Hi,
I'm Archie, and this episode I wanted to talk about independent media, not just public access television, which you're watching now, but the internet, which you may also be watching. Though my show, Hope Now What, is primarily a local variety arts program in Portland, Oregon, I wanted to take this episode to highlight two people who are using the media, who are very passionate about what they have to say, Douglas Bickford and Alex Ansary.
I want people to know what our government is, and they are not nice people.
I feel connected to the future generations that have not been born yet. I think I want to make a difference.
And this is how they dumb us down, okay? As our government sits off the coast of Iran and Iraq, occupying Iraq, and our government sits off the coast of Iran ready to attack Iran. And this is what the media does to us, okay? Brangelina twins are here. Angelina Jolie has given birth to a girl and a boy. The obstetrician who delivered the twins, Dr. Michael Sussman, told the Associated Press that the actress, the baby, and Jolie's partner, Brad Pitt, are doing marvelously well. Sussman said Jolie gave birth to a boy, Knox Leon, and a girl, Vian Marshalline, by cesarean section on Saturday night. All right, there you go. That's all I'm going to read of this story, because the only reason they run this stuff is to keep you dumbed down. Now, if these so-called rich and famous people, Angelina Jolie and Brad Pitt, cared about you and me, why don't they open their mouth about the U.S. government? I'll tell you why they don't. Maybe because they're part of this global elite, New World Order elites.
We have to be prepared if we are going to stay alive and take care of our family. To grow food, to work with one another, to actually learn what it means to be civically responsible in our own communities, in our own neighborhoods. I mean, what do you think is going to happen when the police department cannot afford to pay its officers? When we have layoffs, we have a breakdown in the basic fundamentals of the social order. That will be a catastrophe. How are you prepared to feed your family? How are you prepared to protect your wife, your children, the people that you love? This is not some rant about getting the guns and getting the farm. A lot of us won't have that option. And time and money are two things that we independently and collectively as a nation are running out of. People expect that you must have this crystal clear solution, a way to be the leader for everybody. And I think that's part of the problem. In our own communities, we have to be responsible. We have to be prepared to engage our neighbors in dialogue and a fallout. Most of all, for the safety of our women and children, we have to be prepared to police our own streets without getting caught up in some militia movement or vigilante psychology, where we ourselves are also living in terror and paranoia, wondering who the enemy is. I do believe, before all of this is finished, that each one of us will be tested on some level or another. How strong is your spirit psychologically as you face the news about your economy imploding around you, as you witness your career falling apart around you, as you witness more and more money, zeros and ones, being deducted for a wide variety of reasons from your checking account? Who are you really? Where are you? What is your true value?
The following interviews with Douglas Bickford and Alex Ansary were conducted using the free software Skype. It allows you to place video and audio calls
to anyone who also has downloaded and installed the program and who is also online. The learning curve wasn't terrible. I learned how to use the software and place these calls to Alex and Douglas just before I conducted the interviews. There were some technical glitches that I did my best to smooth over in the editing, but all in all, it was a pretty error-free experience.
If you remember, I don't know if you ever did this when you were a child or coming up through high school, I had a teacher that sat down seven of us in seven chairs, and I think it was in my sophomore year in high school, and he wanted to show us how the mind works, right? So he sat down seven of us in seven chairs, and he whispered something into the ear of the first person.
We did that in school too. By the time it gets to the last person, it's completely different.
Yes. Okay, now here's why I started making my videos, my new videos. Because what's happening is the media is corporate controlled. I'm talking about basically, our media is feeding us propaganda and lies. Okay. Now, to go back to that story, if he whispered something into the first person's ear, and by the time it got to the seventh chair, the seventh person, it was completely opposite, not even close to what he even said. Okay. So what happens is your mind, everybody perceives things in different ways. Okay. But he wanted to prove that by doing that little experiment, right? Now think about this one. And this is why I came up with my new videos, Headline News with Douglas Bickford. Think about, I believe that the headline news we're getting is a lie, right? And I've proven it over and over in my first 20 videos with my new videos. I prove it that they're lying to us. Okay, so the corporate media, state-run television media, comes out with a lie, right, at headline news. So they put that on CNN, Fox, or wherever it goes, right? It goes all over the planet via the television. They start off this lie, right? And you got millions of people watching television, okay? So everybody perceives that lie different, okay? Now think about the seven chairs with just seven people. Now think about that on a massive scale. You're talking millions, billions of people perceiving, which the corporate media comes up with a lie to begin with. They start it with a lie. Now think about that one on a huge implication, or the implication of that.
It just gets more twisted and confused.
Yes, it gets more twisted and confusing. Now here's the thing. The corporate media, the U.S. government, the New World Order, okay, and I'm going into the New World Order, which a lot of people don't know what it is, but it's 300 rich families dominating the planet through the U.S. government, and it's all true. All you got to do is Google search New World Order, you'll see what I'm talking about. But anyway, they came up with that because they know the psychology that of the mind, right? A lot of the U.S. government's principles came from Sigmund Freud. Consumerism is one of them, to make us go out and buy, spend all your money on stuff that you don't need. Then you turn around, take perfectly good stuff that's good, you throw it away and you buy something new. But it's consumerism, and we are like the biggest consumers in the world, the USA, but we turn around and throw away perfectly good stuff to buy new. And I could get off onto that, but I won't. But anyway, back to the original subject. The lie they feed us spreads mass confusion all over the world. I'm talking about all over the planet. And the way they've done it to us, the New World Order, the U.S. government, is through the television. They start the lie, right? And then everybody perceives it differently. And it depends when the human mind works, right? It depends on how you're raised, and all kinds of stuff goes into it as what your brain tells you, or you hear information, it comes into your brain, and then you can either, you hear what you want to hear, basically, is what's happening, and then your mind will turn it to, like, if you don't want to hear something bad, you'll perceive it different. Then you'll go tell somebody what you thought you heard, and it's different than what you heard. I'm exposing the lies that we get from the headline news. I'm talking about all the headline news all over the planet, which I get all mine from off the internet, which is Yahoo News or AOL News. Here's one for you, Archie. Think about this. Now, me and Archie and I are on Skype. All of you out there that want to talk to me or Archie, download Skype. It's free. And we're having like a conversation here, looking at each other. This is like the future. This is technology that is good for people like us. Okay, now, what has happened with the technology, right? We're using the government's technology against them, basically, because we're exposing truth. And the thing is, I started making my videos, okay, because of 9/11, right? One of the reasons was I saw this guy named Kevin Cosgrove. He was on the 100th and something, 110th floor, I think. And he was on the phone with 911, right? And he was just like begging them to come help him. And as he's talking on the phone, you see the buildings. He's on, because he's online, live with 911, you know, the emergency dispatch. And the lady said, oh, yeah, we got somebody coming to you and everything. And as she's talking to him on the phone, you will see the buildings just collapse. And all of a sudden, you just hear a, oh, my God, and that's it. And as you're watching the buildings collapse, that's what you're hearing on the phone. That's the first time I seen, and that wasn't until summer of 2006 that I saw that, because I never watched a 9/11 ever, any of the video coverage of it until summer of 2006, because it was so, I just couldn't watch it. But that was the first thing I watched, and it started me on my truth mission, I guess, because it made me cry when I saw that guy die. And it's all over YouTube. All you gotta do is YouTube search Kevin Cosgrove, and you'll see it. And it made me cry. Okay, and that was like my very first thing that started getting me on my mission to expose 9/11. The truth is going to pop about who did 9/11 to the world.
I believe that evil, you know, by its very nature, is self-destructive.
Yes. I agree.
So, you know, I don't know what form it will take or how long it will take, but evil will destroy itself, you know, like a snake eating itself.
Yes, it is. It's in the process. All of you out there watching me, God, Jesus, Allah, the creator of the universe, and I don't care if you believe in a higher power or not, he's really alive, he's real, and he's the one bringing truth. He's going to bring peace, and he's not going to let evil man destroy Mother Earth, right? So for all of you out there watching me today, have a great spirit-filled day, and the truth will set you free, free indeed, and all good things are coming. I don't care what anybody says. It's all true. From Douglas Bickford, Truth TV, headline news with me to you.